So basically, we'll be optimizing our Python code with the caching techniques, right? So let's say we have this numbers. Let's say you computed the 11, then the 22. So the next time when you want to compute 11, right? So it's gonna check in the hash map. If it is there, then it's just gonna give the answer right away. So let me just run this and show you a sample run. So here you can see it's gonna take 3 seconds for it's computing the 11 square, that is 121, and after that 22 square. Sure enough, it does, right? But now if I run it again, see the magic, what happens? Since it's already there in the cache, since the value was already previously computed and it's there in the temporary memory, it's gonna be like as quick as possible, like instantaneous, right? So let me show you. For the first two, it's gonna take time. Here you can see the cache, right? And now watch what happens. For the third and fourth, see, instantaneous. So cached, so basically cached, and then you got the value, right? So it was pretty instantaneous, right? That's great. So let's actually make this, or let's actually code it, right? We are gonna implement our own cache. We'll be using LRU cache. That stands for least recently used will be thrown out, right? Whatever was not recently used, you'll throw it out, right? Let me just make some space on my screen so I can have my notes on the other screen so I can read it during the presentation. All right, so let me quickly open Google Chrome and hopefully that will open up in a short time. Think it's a little slow, my computer, because I'm broadcasting the videos right now. So let's go to google.com and I actually wanted to show you a nice picture of LRU. I'm not sure if my internet would be right now that fast, because since the video is being broadcasted on the YouTube right now live. All right, forget about that. Let's just try to code the LRU cache, right? The entire cache. All right, let's get started. So I'm gonna make the font a little big so it's easy for us to read. Okay. LRU cache, right? So the first thing is what you're gonna do is basically we'll define a function, LRU cache. It's gonna inherit from object by default. Now, as I said, we are making our cache, right? So the cache should have a capacity. So CAPACITY, capacity, right? And this capacity would be capacity, right? Now, I'm gonna create two hash maps or data structures or dictionary, whatever you wanna call. Called as self.cache. I'm gonna create one more called as self.lru, and I will explain you in a while what this does, right? Functions. So meanwhile, if you have any more questions or comments, anything you wanna ask me, you can write it on the comments, because since it's a live, I can actually interact with you and, you know, answer your questions on the go. All right, so we have the LRU, we have the cache, right? Now let us define a variable called as TM, which is basically gonna keep a track of how many times that member was accessed, right? I'll show you, don't worry about that, okay? So that's done. Now basically we wanna define a get method, which is gonna get the data from the cache. So I'll define the get method like this. Remember, comments is very important in any piece of code, right? So basically get the data from the cache, right? So after that, right? So we wanna get the data. So what we can do is basically, first of all, we can check whether the key exists or not. Of course, the get will take a key because, so let's check if self, or let's say if key in self.cache, initially there is nothing, right? So if key in self.cache, if it is there, right, that means the key is there, right? So what we'll do is self.lru. So we'll give that key self.lru. We give that key and we assign the value called self.tm. I'm gonna explain you what this is going on. So what this does basically is let me just write it down in English here. So this means if key exists, right? If the key exists in the cache, so what this will do basically, let's say you said, let me give a comment here. Let's say assuming it's a dictionary, right? So let's say you said name, you gave the value name as sawmill, right? Like this. So let's say you gave, you are asking for only one time. So this is gonna be name zero. Next, let's say again you accessed it. So it's gonna change it to 1, 2, 3. How many ever time you access it, the number will change. So basically this is kind of a, like a priority. How many time that number was accessed or that data was accessed, right? All right, so don't worry if the video is a little lagging right now. I would upload the clean video that I have it, right? I'm also recording and saving it on my computer, so I'm gonna make sure that I upload that video, right? So yeah, so we have self.tm, right? We have done that. That's amazing. Now we can tell the user, like we can just give a message cached, which basically means that this data was a cached data, right? So now we can return that cached data. So we can say self.cache and we can pass in that key, right? If the key was not there at all, right? That means the data, I mean, if key is not there, that means we can say it was a cache miss, right? So we can simply return -1, which will say that it's a cache miss. Now let us define our set function basically, which will set the data in the cache. So it's gonna take key and value. So what we'll do is basically the set function, first we need to check whether the length of the cache does not exceed the capacity, right? So we can say, so if we can say length self.cache, right? If the length of the cache is greater than self.capacity, which means the capacity that we have defined for the basically the stack, then find the least entry. So let me explain you. So if the capacity of the cache is greater than the capacity that we mentioned, that means it's time to remove something. Okay, so we want to remove something, right? So remember, we will remove only the element that is least accessed in the cache, right? So let us define old key, the minimum key, right? And this will make sense once we run it. Okay, I'll explain you. So we'll say self.lru.keys, right? We'll say keys. And then we want to sort this based on the key lambda k colon, and we'll pass in all the keys. So self dot lru and pass in the variable key. Okay, we have the old key. Now we need to remove that, right? So basically what we could have done is now simply pop the elements from both the cache and the LRU, right? So let me write that code. Right? Remove that, right? So basically we found the key that was least being used in the cache. That means that variable or the data was not being used for a long time. And since the capacity is more, we need to add a new element. So we'll discard the old element, the last element, right? That's how the cache works, right? Else So basically, if the memory was not, the capacity was not greater than the what we mentioned, that means we have some space in the cache. So we can simply insert that into the cache. So we can say self.cache. We can provide the key where we want to insert it, and then we can provide the value. And remember, we need to also update the LRU, which is also keeping a track of how many times each stuff was accessed, right? So, and then we can say self.tm. Now what we can do, self.tm is equal to, we can say self.tm, because we need to increment that, right? That's a counter. Of course, when we run this, it will make sense, right? Now, let me print this for you. And now we'll try it out and show you, basically. So let me create if underscore name underscore underscore is equal to underscore underscore main, right? The under methods, right? Simple, right? So I think we have a typo here. So have any questions in the during this video, please post it. Since I'm live, I can basically answer your questions right away. Okay. So what we'll do is basically we'll say cache dot set. So initially let's set the name. So now this is there in the cache, right? But before even doing that, let's create object LRU cache. And remember, we need to supply the capacity, I would say 10 for now. Let's run this and see what do we get on the output console for our understanding purposes. So initially there is nothing on the cache, right? So this basic, let me see, we have a small issue. Name error, self is not defined. All right, let's correct that. I think I have messed up the indentation. Let's indent that a little bit, right? Now let's try to run this. Oops, still we have issue. It's gonna blow up again. So I will correct that. Oh, it did not. That's good. So here you can see, guys. So initially the LRU. So I have accessed the name variable only once, right? So if I access it once again, or if I do basically, now let's see what happens. So remember, the name count would be changed to 1 because you accessed it 2 times, right? So the most recently accessed data was name, which was accessed, sorry, 1 time, right? 0 and 1, so that is 2, right? So here you can see, right? Similarly, now if I say cache dot set, let's set the age 24 years, yeah. So I'm gonna run that, and now if you see the order, basically how it's working, right? So now when you set, this age is not there in the cache, right? So here you can see initially it was 0, right? So name got 0, then name got 1 because we accessed the name once again. So that is the most recent access data. Then we said name equals to 1 and age is equal to 2. Now, if you observe, name was 1 and age is 2 because now most recently accessed data is age. The name was accessed previously. So the age got a number of 2, right? And inside the cache, we have the data, name and age. So you can see how basically, how efficiently or how basically the cache works, right? Now, similarly, as I said, I had an example for you. So what I did is basically this number computes the square of the whatever number it is, you just compute the square. So guys, we don't want this like to compute every time. Even if we have done the computations in the past, we don't want to waste our CPU usage. So what I did is basically data equals to cache.getNums. So it's going to get the numbers. So if the data is equal to -1, that means that number was not there in the cache. It's a cache miss, right? So then we'll do the computation. Result equals to num into num. Then we'll set that number in the cache, right? The number and the value. We'll sleep for 3 seconds and then we return the result. But if that number was already there in the cache, just return it, right? So that's pretty quick, right? So you get it how the cache works. So for example, if I want to show you this again, as I said, copy that, copy. So now here you can see this should actually take 3 seconds for 1, right? 3, 6, 9 seconds, right? but see how much time it takes. It's pretty fast because it's the data is for the second time, the data is already there in the cache. So it's going to be like quick. So here you can see for the next two times, see how fast it was. You can see 121, 121. So the data was cached basically. It was cached and it was returning the cache data. So it did not had to spend time in computation, right? Guys, whenever you're designing any API or database, please make sure to include this LRU cache, right? It's a very, very important concept. All the programmers should know this. These are some of the fundamental stuff, right? So hopefully you have enjoyed this amazing tutorial. And I want to thank this guy because I have taken the code or I have referenced the code from this blog. As a programmer, it's very important that if you are taking code from anywhere, you do mention their links, right? So I'm going to mention his link or the blog post from where I learned this, right? So that's a good, basically, because if you're taking it. So the name of the guy is Kun Shi. He posted this on the blog on May 27th of 2014. I have referred his code, right? He has given a very nice explanation. So what I did is basically I just tried to explain this code to you. Now I try to use this in my own application, my own REST APIs, and I could really see the performance of the APIs were much faster than what it was before. For example, in the web scraping code, I converted the web scraping into API. So I cached the data into the LRU cache, and then it was much quicker in performance. So I would conclude my video right here. If you have any more questions, please list them in the comment section below. And I would be very happy to assist you. If you want the code, I would also list the code. It's on my LinkedIn blog. I would list the, basically, I would also share the link. All the necessary links would be there in the description. Once again, thank you for watching my video. Thank you for all your support and love. Hopefully you will learn a lot in future. I'm gonna create a lot of videos or education contents basically on programming, right? So that's it for this video. Keep smiling, keep coding, and I would see you guys in the next video. Once again, thank you for watching.